Here we're introducing the LabVIEW programming environment created by the company National Instruments. LabVIEW stands for Laboratory Virtual Instrument Engineering Workbench. Here the base LabVIEW is extended with the LEGO Mindstorms module. This module allows the programming and control of LEGO Mindstorms, specifically the EV3 programmable brick. When you write code within LabVIEW, what the code you're writing is called G. This is the graphical programming language. G consists of a series of functions that are connected together by wires. Each program that you write is called a VI. This stands for Virtual Instrument. This is a virtual version of a scientific instrument. To give it a sense of this, I've Google image searched scientific instrument panel to show a range of different scientific instruments. And what you can see in common here is that each of these have characteristic inputs like knobs, controls, and buttons, as well as a variety of outputs, lights, and other meters. Within our virtual instruments, we have the same types of things. In terms of inputs, we call those within LabVIEW controls. The wires and functions, that's going to be the code that we write, and it's called the block diagram. And then finally, we have our outputs, which might be our indicators. What's great in these virtual instruments is that you can easily change these versus the physical devices that are harder to change. If you've ever programmed LEGO before, for instance, the WeDo platform, or if you've used the NXT or EV3 software, this idea of inputs, outputs, and then graphical programming will be familiar. Partially because these were also written in LabVIEW. For different examples of where LabVIEW has been used, visit poweredby.labview.com. And there they have a variety of examples where LabVIEW has been used on anything from the LEGO products all the way up to the CERN Large Hadron Collider.